Stop. Have you ever checked the ingredient list of your dishwashing liquid?
But why?
If not, check it now. Do they contain anything?
Nowhere it's mentioned.
For hand wash liquid, all the ingredients are clearly mentioned. But none of these dishwasher liquids have mentioned the ingredient list. Why? We are washing the utensils with our own hands, right?
Because they might be using chemicals such as triclosan, sodium lauryl sulfate and phosphates. That might be very harmful for your body.
Triclosan, an antibacterial and antifungal compound. It has been proven that this chemical has its harmful effect on our immune system. Sodium lauryl sulfate, which is generally used as a foaming agent that helps clean the surface of utensils. It may be absorbed by skin cells and may lead to rashes and allergic reactions. Phosphates that releases into water bodies through your drainage system causes algae formation that adversely affects the ecosystem.
However, nothing has been documented till date, but experts believe that manufacturers use these chemicals in various permutations and combinations along with fragrances, dyes and other preservatives, which are obviously harmful for your body.
They also believe that even after washing the utensils under running water, it is expected that some particles of these chemicals stick to plates, cutlery and utensils and harm the body in the long run.
According to Consumer Affairs India, none of these detergents have applied for eco-friendly certificate. Neither do they have mentioned their ingredient list, nor do they have eco mark on them.
Remember the advertisements of these famous brands? They say they contain extra power of lemon. So why can't we use a lemon directly? Because they're easily available in the market, nicely packed, good fragrance, and they last longer. Plus, they do the job fast. So why make it at home?
What if we say that the cleaners that you can make at home will cost you half of what you're spending on the brands? And also, they are not harmful to the body and eco-friendly too. Isn't it a win-win situation?
Take 6 lemons, de-seed them and cut them into small pieces. Then boil them in approximately 2 glasses of water for roughly 20 minutes till they are completely soft. Let it cool for some time. Then grind it to a fine paste. Strain it to remove any lumps. Then to this mixture add 1/2 cup of sea salt or rock salt and 1/4 cup of white vinegar. Boil it for roughly 10 minutes and your mixture is ready. This is a very strong cleaning agent. It can actually clean the toughest of the stains, which none of the brands can do. This we are speaking on the basis of our experience. Take 1/4 cup of baking soda. Then add 1/2 cup of white vinegar. There will be bubble formation, but once the bubbles have settled, add 1 cup of water. To it add few drops of tea tree oil. Tea tree oil works as a disinfectant, also it gives a nice fragrance to the detergent. And your detergent is ready. You can spray it in a glass bottle and use it to clean the toughest of the stains. Soak 100 grams of soap nut overnight, de-seed them and boil them along with lemon and orange peels for roughly 20 minutes. Cool the mixture and grind it into fine paste. To this liquid you add 1 cup of sea salt or rock salt, boil it for 10 minutes and in the end add 1/2 cup of white vinegar. Cool the mixture and then strain it. Your liquid detergent is ready to use. Soapnuts are anti-allergic and antibacterial by nature, and that is why they are widely used in hand washers and liquid detergents. If you want more foam, you can increase the quantity of soapnuts in your liquid detergent. Time has come for the consumers to take the lead in prompting the manufacturers to adopt a clean and an eco-friendly technology. Whatever chemicals we are using in our home goes down the drains into groundwater and polluted. In many communities, if wastewater treatment facilities are there, then they are only designed to treat organic materials, not hazardous chemicals. If you pour hazardous chemicals down the drain, they might end up in your local rivers, lakes, and coastal waters, polluting the marine life, which in turn comes back to us via plants and animal food. We are a part of this ecosystem. It's a complete cycle.
What we give is what we receive. We can't change the world in a single day, but slowly we all can.
The first step towards Swachh Bharat begins from our home. We have started replacing these chemicals with more natural cleaners, and we hope you all too.